welcome back to the one more video session of Microcontroller and Embedded System Laboratory. This is Vasant Nayak from Canara Engineering College. In this video, we will study the 12th experiment of 18CS44 syllabus of UTU, that is determine the digital output for a given analog input using ARM controller. Normally, ARM based controller, that is we are using LPC2148 in our lab, which is based on ARM7 TDMI processor, that has contained two built-in ADC, that is ADC0, ADC converter 0 and ADC converter 1. ADC converter 0 has got 6 channels and AD converter 1 has got 8 channels. We'll see that one. So in order to give variable voltage, we will connect a module with the pot. We will connect a module with pot in order to give variable voltage to this internal ADC. Now let's see first the information related to ADC. What is the ADC? So ADC is an analog to digital converter, which is used to convert analog signal voltage into digital value and process that number and make it human readable. So the LPC2148 based microcontroller contains internal ADC. LPC2148 microcontroller, which is based on ARM7 TDMI technology, which has got two ADC, internal ADC, built-in ADC, and these two ADC are of type for 10-bit ADC, that is a built-in 10-bit ADC, and it works on the principle of a successive approximation analog to digital converter. So in the video related to the analog to digital converter, I have explained what is successive approximation ADC. You can refer that one. So, but whatever the ADC which is built in LPC2148 makes use of successive approximation, and it is 10-bit in the sense like 10-bit in the sense like so it can take the minimum value is equal to 0 and maximum value is equal to 2^10, that is 2^10 is equal to, you will get 1024. So the number of samples between this and this will be 1024. So minimum value is 0 and maximum value is 1023. So it is based on the formula 2^n-1. So n is a number of resolution of ADC, that is a 10-bit ADC, minus 1, which gives 1024. So 0 to 1023. So this 0 correspond to input voltage of 0, and this 1023 is correspond to input voltage of maximum voltage of 3.3 volt, because LPC2148 works on 3.3 volt technology. So this 0 to 3.3 volt analog input is converted into corresponding digital output. So you give the analog input of peak value of 3.3 volt, and that will be converted by sampling that input signal. So around 1023 samples will be taken from this one and it will be converted. Now we have to see what is the resolution, or what is the step value, what is the resolution, or what is the step value of this analog input voltage. So resolution will define a smallest change in the output for the change in the input. For example, if the input is 0000, so for a particular change in the input, if the input is 0000, output will be 000. for a particular change in the input, what the particular change in the input that makes changes from 0000 to 0001, that is called as a resolution. So normally resolution is calculated based on the formula. I will discuss it in the next slide. So student, ADC resolution is defined as the smallest incremental voltage that can be recognized and thus cause change in the digital output. As I said, a smallest incremental voltage that can be recognized and that cause change in the digital output. How you calculate the resolution or step size? You calculate the resolution or step size by using this formula, that is input range resolution into resolution, input range into resolution. So what is the input range? That is 3.3 volt. And the resolution is, we are using 10 bit ADC. So it can, so 2 raised to power n is equal to 2 raised to power 10, that is 1023. That gives 3.23 millivolt. This is the smallest change in the input that causes the output, digital output to change. So now we have LPC21488. In that, it has got two built-in ADC, ADC 0 and ADC 1. ADC 0 has 6 channels from AD 0.1 to 0.6. ADC 1 has 8 channels, AD 1.0 to 1.7. So in our experiment, in our demonstration, we are using ADC 0. ADC 0. In our demonstration, you are using ADC 0 with the 0.1 channel. So this 0.1 channel is connected to, 0.1 channel is connected to, you can see here, pin number, port number 0.28 pin. So port number 0.28 pin, we are going to give input signal, like input voltage. Port number 0.28, we are giving input. We are giving input. So we need to configure this pin, port 0.28. So we need to configure this pin for analog to digital function. So we'll see this one by using pin select register. So now I'll take you to the pin select register where we'll see how to configure port 0.28. So first, let's see port 0.28. You can see here in this diagram, port 0.28 has got four functions. First one is general GPIO, general purpose input output. Second one is AD converter 0.1, that is AD converter 0. ADC 0 in that first channel. Then other than that, it has got two more functions. So you need to configure this port number 0.28 for the second function, not for the first function. For the second function, you need to configure. So to configure second function, we know to configure each pin, we use 2 bit. If it is 00, if this bit 1 and bit 2, if bit 1 and bit 2 is 00, then it will be configured for first combination. If it is 01, it will be configured for second combination. 10, it will be configured for third combination. 11, it will be configured for fourth combination. So we need to configure it for the second configuration. So this value we need to configure. For that we need to select this functionality. For that we have to use pin select one register. Why we need to use pin select one register? Let's see. So let me close this one. Let us go to this file. So we have three pin select registers in LPC2148. All are 32 bits. That is pin select register 0, pin select register 1, and pin select register 2. Pin select register 0 used to configure port 0.0 to port 0.15. Pin select register 1 is used to configure port 0.16 to port 0.31. And pin select register 2 is used to configure port 1.16 to 1.31. So you need to configure now, we need to configure now port 0.28 pin. So this pin, in order to configure this pin for the second functionality, you need to select pin select register 1, and in that pin select register 1, bit number 24 and 25, you need to configure 01, as I said, for the second functionality. Rest all the bits, you need to configure 0000, something like this. So let me write here 000 so that you will understand in the better way. So one more zero here. Now let us write this in hexadecimal format. So this is the hexadecimal 0. This one is 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 0. And this one is 1. And this one is 0. That means we need to configure pin select 1 as 0x01000000. That is 32 bit format. In hexadecimal, it is in 32 bit. So in hexadecimal, it is represented like this. So you need to configure pin select register for this one. So I hope you understood this one. Now we'll move to the registers of analog to digital converter. So now we'll move to the registers of analog to digital converter. So analog to digital converter has got two registers. One is called as AD control register. Other one is AD global data register. Control register, you need to do the configuration for analog to digital conversion. And global data register, you will get the output. The output will be stored in global data register along with the done bit. That is the 31st bit of analog global data register. Is if it is 1, that indicates conversion is done. And ADC analog like control register, AD control register, you need to configure it for the configuration. You need to configure it for the conversion. So let's see now first what is there in analog digital control register, analog to digital control register. So this is the format of analog to digital control register, where 0 to 7 bits, this one is used for select the channel. Then bit number 8 to 15 is used for clock division. I will come to that one. Other than that, we need these bits are not required in our case. So we need to understand this bit, 21st bit, that is power down. Power down means normally ADC will be in the power down mode. So in order to make it power up, you need to make this bit as 1. Then other than that, we have here bit number 24, 25, 26. So this bit is enabled, like bit number 26 is 0, 25 is 0, and 24 is 1. So 001 will make the start of the conversion process. If you give 001, that will make the start of the conversion process. So let's see now first. So in our case, I am using AD0 first channel. So in order to select this channel, so here we have 8 bits, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I need to enable, that is second bit, or in bit second bit I need to enable, that is 00000010. I need to enable this bit. I need to enable this bit. This is actually, it is a second bit, but normally we will start counting of bit from bit 0 to bit 7. So that's why it is the first bit. Now in this case it's the first bit, you need to enable it. In case you are going to use AD0.2, then you need to enable this one. So next we will move to the clock division. So we are using 12 MHz, actually LPC2148 works at 12 MHz, and our ADC converter works at 3 MHz. So in order to achieve 3 MHz clock frequency from 12 MHz, in order to achieve 3 MHz peripheral clock frequency from 12 MHz, you need to divide this one by 4. So 4 is the division factor. So here you need to enter this one, you need to enter 00000100, that is nothing but 4. This is nothing but 2. After that, we need to enable bit number 21 high. You need to enable bit number 21 high. So from 16 to 19, we will ignore. So this value in XI is 0. 20, 21, 22, 23, 21 bit is 1. So this value is in XI is 2. This value in XI is 2. Other than that, 24, 25, 26, 27, we will make it 0, 0, 0, 1. So this value in XI is 1. And last, the 28 to 31 is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So here you will get totally 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 0, 0, 4, 0, 2. So this one you need to write in the control register, that is AD0CR register should be loaded with this value. So let us proceed now. Now we'll go to the next control register, that is global data register. I told you the purpose of global data register is to save the result. So here you can see 32 bit global data register. Let me zoom it. In that, result is stored between pin number 6 and 15. 6 and 15 result is stored, and pin number 31 indicates if it is 1, it indicates conversion is over. Conversion is complete. That means pin number 31, if it is 1000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Why I am telling you this one is in the later in the program, we will check this bit condition to check, we will use this one to check whether conversion is over or not. So results are stored here in between 6 and 15. So once the results are stored, we need to right shift the content by 6 bit so that it will be adjusted from 0 bit onwards. We'll see that one. So now we'll move to the program. So I'm using here LPC214X adder file. It is a generic adder file for 214X based board. Then I will include C library like stdio.h, stdintegr.h and string.h. Why I am using string.h is finally I need to display the digital value. For example, digital values, if I take some digital value 1111111111, this is the digital value I want to display in decimal. I want to display this one decimal for easy understanding. So while displaying decimal, I will convert decimal into this one into string, and I will display. For example, if it is a 3.3 volt, then I will convert this one 3.3 into string and I will display. For that purpose, we are using here string.h. And before proceeding, I will tell you, you can display the result either using a UART or you can use seven segment display, or you can use the LED display panel to display this one. So in our case, we are using UART to display the result, that is analog to digital conversion. So now that's why we have a prototype here, UART 0 for UART initialization and delay for delay function. So this is a definition of UART initialization, where we have used pin select register 0 is assigned with the 000005. This is because I want to use port number 0.0 and port number 0.1 for TXT, transmit data and receive data purpose. So that's why we are using this value. For more information, please refer my video on UART. Then the line control register value should be 0x83. This will set divisor latch bit enable and character length is equal to 8 bit. And we are loading a divisor latch register MSB and LSB with this value based on our calculation. Then we are disabling divisor latch enable bit. In order for transmission purpose, you need to disable in order to store character in transmit UART transmit old register. You need to disable divisor latch bit. So when you disable divisor latch bit, you will get this value. So you can refer my video on UART. So you will get more detail there. I am not going to discuss this in detail here. So now we have a function here. So send character. So send character will send the character to the terminal based on the condition of the line status register and hexadecimal number 40. So before moving to send string function, I will take you to the main function. In the main function, I have taken two variable, ADC data and voltage of type int and float. Then I have taken one array to store the result. That is, one will store analog voltage, other will store digital voltage, digital reading. Then I have enabled pin select register with this value as explained earlier. Then I have loaded AD0 control register with this value as I told earlier. Then inside the while loop, I will check whether the conversion is over with the AD0 data register. I will check this condition. If the conversion is over, then what I will do is I will take that value. I will take that entire 32 bit register and AND it with the FFC in order to get bit from 6 to 15. In order to get bit from 6 to 15, rest all bit it will mask. Then I will shift that value right to the right, and I will store that value in ADC data. So when you shift this value to the right, so all this value will be get shifted by six bits to the right, and it will be stored in ADC data. Finally, I will use the formula ADC data divided by 1023 into 3.3. So this is the input. Suppose you take input some value 2.2. divide by 1023 resolution into reference voltage 3.3, that will give you the digital value. So I will calculate that value, and I will assign that value using sprintf statement. Sprintf is the statement in embedded C where you are going to assign voltage to volt. It will not print, but it will assign, and ADC data to DG volt, like this. This one it will assign. After that, after that, I will call UART initialization function. Then I will use send string to send this character to the display. Then I will send the value of DG volt and volt. So what is there in send string? So in the send string, so this is the delay function. So in that send string, we have like send string. It will take the pointer of type character. Then it will count the number, count the, like I am using one variable here, count, that will count the string length, and that will be assigned to this variable length. After that, I will send two characters, ASCII characters, line feed and carriage return, to go to next line on the display. Then I will display entire character by character by using send character, character by character by using this function. I will display character by character. So this is the program, student. Now because of lockdown, I don't have the controller to show the demonstration. So but we'll see how it will work for to show you some sort of output here, how it works exactly by using simulation. What I will do is, instead of AND condition, I will use OR condition in my program, so that I can show you the simulated output. Once the situation becomes situation set right, that time we will see the actual demo along with this video. So now we'll go to Keil version 4 software. In the Keil version 4 software, I have already project. So the project is opened, and this is the actual code what I explained you right now. And here, in order to explanation purpose, instead of using AND condition, I will use OR condition. Now, after this, before compile, you add startup.s file. It is required because in order to execute embedded C, you need startup.s. Then do the necessary settings in options for target, like device, target, you need to select microlib, and this frequency output, you need to enable exa file. Then listing, C processor listing is required. Then linker, you need to enable this one. Once this is over, then you compile. So zero errors and zero warnings, build and rebuild. It will create exa file based on the project name. Once this is over, you have to go to Flash Magic. So let's open Flash Magic software. Flash Magic is a software used to dump the code to the LPC2148 controller. So here you need to do the settings related to COM port, baud rate, interface, like interface and oscillator's frequency. Then you need to select the particular exa file. For example, in our case, it is experiment number 12, and this is the exa file. I will select and I will click on start button. So when you click on start button, this file will be loaded into the microcontroller. As I said, I don't have a LPC2148 controller because of lockdown. I don't have readily available this one now. So we will see the output in the simulated form. For that, I will go to the Keil, this one. I will open the project once again here. So I will go to debug mode. Then I will go to view, and in the view, I will select UART 1, and I will click on execution of the code in one go. So you see here, it will display the output continuously. The output will be like input value and input value and corresponding decimal value of the output. This is the decimal value of the corresponding output and this is the input value. For example, if the input is 3.3 volt, then the decimal output is you will get decimal output will get 1023. So this is the explanation of the program. Along with this, you see the actual demonstration of the program. Thank you. And today we will see analog to digital converter experiment. So this is the LPC2148 kit. It is based on ARM7-TDMI microcontroller. You can see here. So LPC2148 based on ARM7-TDMI microcontroller. And this is the supporting kit for that controller. So this is the ADC card. I am going to connect to the FRC1 connector, as I said in the explanation part, FRC1 connector. After this, I will plug on the power. This is 9 volt DC I am connecting to the power point. So after making all this connection, you need to connect the controller or LPC2148 to the PC through USB to serial cable, SPI cable, through SPI cable. This is the SPI cable. So let me show the connection. So this cable has got one end SIP protocol, SIP interface that you need to connect it to the LPC2148 USB UART interface, and other end you need to connect it to the PC. So once done, you need to switch on the power supply. So make sure on the kit, please switch off PWM switch and switch on UART switch and ISP switch. ISP is nothing but in system programming. So switch on ISP and UART to enable UART. So now let us open Keil version software. So I am going to open Keil Microvision version 4. If any project is open, let me close the project and let me open the new project. Open project. So I am browsing the particular directory in which the project is stored. So in this case it is ADC, in my case it is ADC new, in this one ADC 14. Here I have a project related to ADC. So I will click on this one. So now the project is opened and you can see the code as explained earlier in the explanation session. Now, once this is done, you need to compile this file. For compiling, you need to enable certain option in target. So I'll click on the option for the target. Here you need to enable 12 MHz crystal frequency and enable use microlib. So target, you need to select, sorry, device you need to select LPC2148. Here it is selected here, LPC2148. Output, you need to enable create EXA file. Then listing, you need to enable C preprocessor listing. Then linker, you need to enable use memory layout for the target dialog. Once this settings is done, then click on OK and click on build and compile. So translate, click on translate. Zero errors and zero warnings. You can see here zero errors and zero warnings. Then click on build and rebuild. So build and rebuild.
So you can see here the EXA file is created on the name of project file, ADC project. So EXA file is created and it is stored in the particular directory. So once this is done, so after that I will use FlashMagic software. So I will use the FlashMagic software. This software is used to transfer whatever EXA file, whatever you have created, from the PC to the microcontroller. From the PC to the microcontroller. So here you need to select device. So I am going to select LPC2148. Under FlashMagic, you have to select LPC2148. And you need to select the COM port. For selecting the COM port, you need to go to computer, right click, properties, right click, device manager. Device manager under COM and LPT section, you can see here our board, like from Silicon Lab, is connected to the UART bridge. So it is using COM port 3. So in the FlashMagic, you need to select COM port 3. And baud rate is 19,200. Then interface is none. That is, we are using inline system programming. Oscillator frequency is 12 MHz. Then enable this option, erase all the flash code. Then verify after programming, enable these options. So then browse the directory where you have stored the project file, EXA file. Go to the directory. So in my case, it is ADC14. So I will go to ADC14 directory. Here EXA file is there. I will select the file. I will open the file and I will click on start button. Once you click on the start button, it will dump the code from PC to the microcontroller. It will dump the code from PC to the microcontroller. Let me click on start button. Start button. When you click on start button, you can see here program will getting dumped into the microcontroller. So here you can see the status of the program dumping. Once it dumps the program completely, you can see the finish button here. So after this, go to tool and click on terminal. So we are going to see the output of analog to digital converter. So you just click on tool. There is an option terminal. So here we are going to see the analog to digital converter output on the terminal screen. So click on terminal. So in the terminal also you need to select the COM port 3. So click on OK. So here you can see the output ADC. So this is the analog value 3.3 and this is the corresponding decimal value. For example, I will vary this pot. When I vary this pot, you can simultaneously see the output will vary. Like you can see now. So let me vary, like the decimal settings 97 and corresponding the value 0.3, analog value 0.3 and digital value is 97, which is not in binary. So here now you can see digital value is 1/10, which is not in binary, which is in decimal value. So like this, by varying the value, you can see the varying the pot, you can see the output. So here the maximum voltage is 3.3 because analog to digital converter in LPC2148 works on the reference voltage of 3.3 volt. Thank you.